Afternoon, everyone. So I'm Sayan Chowdry. I'm a Python Django developer, and I've been working on Python. So I'm a Fedora contributor. I contribute to Fedora projects in the Fedora Infra team. So the Fedora Infra team has a project called Fedmsg. It's known as the Federated Message Bus. So it was prior known as the Fedora Message Bus, but later they changed the name to Federated Message Bus, as the Debian guys also started to using it, because the scenario for which we built this particular piece of software was also the same problems which the Debian guys were facing. So let's start with the what is Fedmsg. So Fedmsg is basically a simple Python package. It basically what it does is that it takes in sends message from to and fro application. So it sends a message to a particular message bus, a virtual message bus, and it's the other applications which are connected to that particular message bus can receive the message. It's just simple as that. Now the problem was with the Fedora team was that there were plenty of disconnected components. Okay, so suppose somebody applies to the Fedora ambassadors team, and now a person manually had to go and create a Bugzilla ticket for that person. And this was getting painful when a lot of people were going to send a ambassador request. And the similar problem existed in all over the Fedora infrastructure. So what they decided was that to build something that is in real time and could solve the problem that the Fedora Infra team had. So Fedmsg is built on top of ZeroMQ, and I will tell the point that it has no central broker, so there would be no single point of failure. Let me explain why we chose this particular, how the architecture was decided. So so Fedora has very critical changes that keeps on happening. Suppose a build is happening. A new package has been updated, so RPM is created for that particular package. So if based on that RPM, a lot of packages, the package maintainer gets notification, and the other package maintainers who are kind of in a subscribed to that list get notified. So if a particular message does not get transferred, so it would be a problem for the package maintainers to continue with the work. So so this is what AMQP, the traditional structure looks like. So there's a producer, and there's a central broker that, to whom the producer sends the message, and then there's a consumer which actually consumes those messages. Now, the problem with this is that suppose if, in our case, the broker goes down, so what happens to the messages that the producer is sending? A lot of things would get disconnected, and a lot of things will fall out of place. So what we thought of as a simple ZeroMQ. So if you have worked on ZeroMQ, there's something known as a ZeroMQ pub-sub pattern. So we build a based on the pub-sub pattern. So the producer connects to a particular port, and the consumer simply connects to that particular port and starts consuming those messages. And this is the basic architecture of the ZeroMQ project. Now let me show you how the complete Fedora infrastructure is divided. So we have different, like the body, we have something like the track where all the like all the tickets are maintained. Then we have a FedoCal for maintaining the meetings and stuff like that. It's just like a calendar. Then we have a Tahir, Asbot. Asbot is a forums, QA support forum. And like Bodhi, where the package maintainers submit their packages. And now, so whenever activity is happening, so every activity is sent over to the particular message bus. So this line that you see in the center is the bus. That is basically the port which is it's connecting to. And then based on those that particular bus, we have a number of consumers that are constantly consuming those messages to work process those particular messages. So we have like a Fedmsg IRC server. So if you go to Freenode and connect to /Fedora/Fedmsg, you can see the number of messages that are coming every minute. And then we have the Fed badges. So Fedora has something called the Fedora badges system, where based on some activity, suppose they have done a blog post, you get a badge. So this is all generated. So when somebody pushes a blog it sends a Fed message message to the message bus, and the consumer, which is the Fed Fed batches, actually consumes and checks if a batch can be awarded to that guy or not. So this is the basic architecture of the Fed message project. So this is like the producer sends a message on a particular topic, and suppose and the consumer that is consuming those messages can subscribe to a particular topic. So the topic is defined as like the org.federalproject.env. Then we have the category, then object, and then event. Now, what is env? So env is basically the environment that we have. So you can set up environment for your staging machine, your production machine, or your local system also. So based on those, you can change the name. So you can give dev, stg, production, or any other name you want. And the producer will consumer will be consuming those messages based on that environment. And then we have the category. So which application category is basically the application that is sending the particular message. So suppose the Koji, that is Koji is sending the message, so it would be like the category would be replaced by Koji. And then we have, suppose Bodhi is sending the message, so the category will be Bodhi. And then we have the object. So suppose in Bodhi, which particular object did that particular activity. So object is something like a user or a tag. So suppose you can build a, so let me give you an example. So we are building a project called AutoCloud. So it has, which actually does image testing. So here we can name the object as image. So the object which we are doing the work on is image. And then sub object is like a more data to the object. So it's just optional. You can use or you can just ignore it. And then we have the event. So event is basically like what action is being performed by that particular user. So it can be update, create, test, running, test failed, something like that. Okay. So these are the list of few topics that we have. You can view the all the topics at fedora-fedmsg.readthedocs.org. And a few examples would be like the aspot is the category object that is category that is sending, and then the post happened, and then operation that was happening was edit. So the topic would be created like aspot.post.edit. Similarly, bodhi.update.comment. So we have a list of example topics that we have. You can go to that particular website and see the list of topics you can subscribe to. Now, so if you want to set up a Fed message on your machine, so this is a command if you want to use for Fedora. So it's sudo dnf install Fed message. Now, when you install Fed message, you will see a file getting created in /etc/fedmsg.d. It would have a list of endpoints. Okay, and the Fedora message that the producer is producing is publicly subscribable. So anybody can subscribe to those messages and create applications out of it. I will show a list of examples, applications that were created out of this bus. So anybody who wants to start contributing to Fedora can simply use these messages to create meaningful projects out of it. So if you hit tcp://hub.fedoraproject.org:9940, that's the public subscribable port that we have. With a ZMQ subsocket, you will able to get all the messages through it. We also have commands inside the Fed message package so that you can directly consume messages without writing the complete ZeroMQ code. Okay. So this is the structure of the file I was talking of. So you have the like a dictionary that you have with the endpoints mapped. And whenever you are, if you want to consume some messages, the messages that will be coming from will be this particular port. Okay. So how to publish messages? So before you can publish message, you have to make an entry to this particular particular endpoint file. So I'll be showing a demo on how you can add a particular endpoint. Okay. So after adding that particular endpoint, you can actually start publishing messages with a particular topic. So here, what I am doing is that I am echoing hello world to the FedMessage logger. So if you do subscribe a particular subscribe to that particular endpoint, you will find all those messages coming to your consumer. Now, suppose you don't want to do it from the terminal and rather write out code in Python and do stuff. So this is the code. So you have to import the FedMessage package, and then you have a FedMessage.publish method, which actually publishes the that particular message to the FedMessage bus. So here you can tell FedMessage that the topic is testing, and then along with the message, there are other options also which you can add, like is the consumer enabled, stuff like that. So this is the way how you write code for publishing messages using a Python code. And if you want to start consuming those messages which are you are publishing to the particular FedMessage bus, so you need to there's a command called FedMessage tail with a lot of options like really pretty, pretty print, and cow say. So you will get the most used is a really pretty. So you will get all the messages in form of a JSON, which will show in your terminal that these are messages are getting published in real time. Now there is the same goes for, suppose you want to do the same thing from Python code. So there's a method called FedMessage.tailMessage, which returns a tuple of name, endpoint, topic, and message. So you can do stuffs based on those variables. So suppose you want to after consuming those messages, you will like to do stuffs on those messages. So you can do activities on those messages, and get meaningful data out of it. Now, suppose you want to when you write start consuming messages, it's like a Python program that is running. But if you want to run in a daemon mode, we have something called a FedMessage.consumer, which is a twisted code which actually connects as a daemon and keeps getting the messages. So we have the topic in here as everything that is that has the org.fedora.project. So what the consumer does is that it gets all the messages that has this particular topic, and then you have to write in the method consume. You have to overwrite that method and do whatever data manipulation you want to do on that particular message. So here what I'm doing is that I'm simply pretty printing the message. And so this is the basic way of three methods of consuming those messages. So now let me show you what things are built on top of FedMessage in the Fedora infrastructure project. So we have a Koji stock, which what it does is that whenever a package is getting built for the primary architecture, it sends out a message to the FedMessage, and it basically rebuilds the package and tests the packages in the secondary architectures. And then we have fast track, which actually listens the problem I was talking of, that it listens to the ambassador project, and it starts creating those Bugzilla tickets. Then the recent project that we built on top of FedMessage was Anitya. So Anitya is basically a tool to check if a project is having a new release or not. And when a project have a new release, the new hotness, the next project that I have is, it basically notifies the packager that you need to update your package now, and there has been a new release. And then we have something as the Fedora News. So suppose you are working on a project and you want to get notified if a particular package has been updated or not, or if a particular image has been tested or not. So you can directly install this FedMessage Notify project, and this is based on Genome, so you will get notifications for that particular tag. Okay. And then Fedora News, Fedora News gives you, there's a simple web page which actually gives you the latest thing that is happening on Fedora. And basically it gets the data from the planet and stuff. And then we have the notification. So the FedMessage Notify, you can disable using the desktop notifications, the Genome shell extension that we have. And then these are the list of things you can do with desktop notifications. So you can turn off a particular if you want to get notifications on IRC meetings, or if you want to get notified on if a particular person is blogging or not. So you can directly configure your Fedmsg notify to give data about it. So then we have a project called Data Normer, which actually stores all the messages into the database. So what the every project that is consuming the message, there's a daemon called Fedmsg Hub that is actually consuming those messages. So what Fedmsg Hub does is that it stores those particular messages in the database, and the project name is Data Normer. So using that database, we have built a REST API for that particular data. So if you want to get all the data that happened previously, so you can directly hit the API endpoints and get the data, old data that happened in the past. So the project that provides the JSON API is the Data Gripper. And then we have a project called This Week in Fedora, which actually gives the list of all the activities happening in Fedora, like what all commits that were pushed and how active are the contributors, how active are the ambassadors, so you can get to know all those stuffs in This Week in Fedora project. And then we have Fedora Badges project that actually it has a Fed Badges daemon, which actually receives Fedmsg data and checks if a particular person needs to be awarded a badge or not. And finally, there is a project called Fedora Notifications, which what you can do is that you using that Fedmsg data, you can get notified. So there is a desktop version to it, which is called Fedmsg Notify, and then there is a separate project that is the FMN, which actually what it does is that it gets the data into IRC, then Android, and email. So you can configure stuffs, like this is the web page. You can build different filters on which you want to get data. Okay, and this is basically for the IRC backend, and then we have like the email backend and the Android backend also. So this is basically done on the basis of the Fedmsg Hub project. So you can, if you want to write your own projects, you can directly create a daemon and start consuming those messages. And like I told you, this the projects like This Week in Fedora, This Week in Fedora was built over just a weekend. So if you want to, during FedCon, I was working on something as like getting all the Fedmsg messages over to Telegram. So you can just go and hack with those data in your and build something good out of it. So so I told you about a project that I was working on called AutoCloud. So since the internet was not working, I could not show the actual logs that are coming in. So here in AutoCloud project, I have something as the email. AutoCloud is a category. So here you can see that the AutoCloud is the category. Object is the image. So the primary work of AutoCloud is to test image and give results on that particular image. And then we have the action as aborted. So the topic comes to as AutoCloud.image.aborted. Okay. So if you see the code for the Fedmsg Hub, so this is what it does. So this is a Fedmsg daemon. And so I have subscribed to a topic called org.fedora-project.prod.buildsys.task.state.change. Okay. Now what it does is that it basically checks in the buildsys project that we have for any change that is happening. And when I'm consuming those messages, I'm checking for a particular message, and based on that, I'm triggering off image test that is happening. And so here you can see like I am publishing those messages to a particular Fedmsg endpoint that I have. So here I am specifying the topic as image.queued, and the mod name, the category that I have is in the method that I've created, like published to Fedmsg, and extra data that I'm sending goes into the message part. So if I show you, so here's my code on how I am publishing those messages. So I have the topic which is being sent to me, and then the mod name as AutoCloud, which is the name of the category, and the message I'm sending over to the Fed message bus so that people, and then based on this data, people are building stuff out of it. So this is a reference from where I took. So we have, we are really active and we really, we push everything to Fed message and based on those Fed message messages, we build meaningful projects out of it. So if you want to contribute to Fedora, so you can start, come into IRC channel on Fedora Infra and directly ping anybody out there to that you want to start contributing. And you will mainly see there are projects, if you go to the Fedora Infra GitHub repo, you will find all the projects which I mentioned are there and has the same code that you have. And the thing I missed was that, so here you can see that I have created, so here you can see that I have created endpoints according to my need to publish. And because in Fedora infrastructure, everything is not, so you cannot directly publish to Fedora, the Fedora infrastructure bus, but you can directly subscribe to it. Because, but for this project, like I got entry into the infrastructure and got code deploy on to publish. So we basically maintain a flat file to get to see which all applications are allowed to push messages into Fed message. So, but if you want to build out small projects out of it, you can directly, if you want to build some real-time apps, you can directly build using this Fed message project. You can directly install it via pip and build things out of it. And so one thing you have to do is that you have to create endpoints based on the category name. And so here, this is basically the name of the module that I'm using. And it's separated by the host name. So, and here I specify the number of ports that I will be publishing to. So there are two ports that I'll publish my messages to. And then the consumer will be basically consuming those messages from this particular ports. So if you want to know more about Fed message, you can directly go over to this presentations and directly go over to the fedmessage.readthedocs.org and check how you can integrate Fed message along with your project to build real-time apps out of it. So this was the end. So do you have any questions?
Yeah. I mean, ZeroMQ is used for transient messages, right?
Yeah.
Shouldn't this be run in a more persistent way?
Yeah. So see, the ZeroMQ thing was that like you can directly subscribe. So here in our scenario was that whenever a consumer connects and it starts getting the messages, and we never found this. There was a problem with the. Messages, like getting the messages. So we are like, when if you go to the IRC channel and see the number of messages getting published, so there is no failover in that case. So, and we also have a project called Fed Message Replay, which actually which was built by the Debian guys, which actually stores the messages, and if you need it, it can replay those messages back to the Fed Message bus.
Yeah, hi. So, a very basic question on your first slide. So, you said like you didn't go with that broker-based architecture, you actually went with ZeroMQ, right?
Yeah.
Which doesn't have a broker. The whole concept of a message queue is basically the whole purpose of broker being there is either the producer or the consumer is not alive at the point of time of sending or receiving. The broker is the one which stores the message and relays it to the either the producer or the consumer at the time when the producer or the consumer comes up back again.
Yeah,
but you're losing that if you don't use the broker architecture, right?
Yeah. So,
in your architecture, if either the producer goes down or the consumer is not available, I'm sure the producer is not going to keep the messages till infinity, right?
It will yeah.
At some point in time, so your consumer can get can miss messages in the yeah. current architecture.
Yeah. So, the consumer loses the suppose the consumer gets down, so it loses the messages for that particular point of time. So and but the problem was that suppose the broker stores the message and the broker goes down, we lose those messages as well. And in this case, we
For that, you have HA for broker, or you can have a cluster of systems working for broker and actually do load balancing across multiple
yeah,
systems.
Yeah, but here the thing was that you can directly subscribe them. So you can directly subscribe to this particular messages. Now, the thing I told to him, like, we have something as the Fedmsg replay that actually replays the messages to, if you want.
Which you are coming back, that's kind of acting as a broker only.
Yeah, but if you are connecting to that particular Fedmsg, so the consumer directly consumes message from the point it starts.
I understand your point, but my basic question is, why not go through this method and why go through the ZeroMQ? What was the original, I'm sure there will be a lot of discussion would have happened on the list on why not this and why not. So I'm just trying to figure out what was the reason you went with a non-broker kind of architecture.
So that was the primary reason, like what if the broker goes down and the messages are lost?
There are a lot of solutions around that, you know, if you just Google as well.
Yeah, but in that case, see, the if the broker goes down, there are no chance of getting those messages, I think.
That's what, this is a cluster way and all, you can have that.
Yeah, you can set up cluster, but...
For example, you know, I'm coming from an OpenStack background. OpenStack uses AMQP, and OpenStack works at a humongous scale, and AMQP works very well in OpenStack.
My question is, you said the for publishing, you had to get some special authorization, right?
Yeah.
So, I mean, is there anything already baked in that eases authentication, or is it like hard-coded on like centralized deployment? I mean, how exactly is authentication handled?
So, in that case, if you are working on your personal system or deploying, installing Fedmsg on your project, yes, there's no authorization that is required. But because Fedora Infra, not everybody can push, right? Because messages are critical, we build on those messages, we do more of stuff. So in that case, we are like blocking those messages to publish. So So this particular area in hub.fedoraproject.org, we actually restrict in that part. Like, you cannot publish those messages. You will find, if you publish, you will not find that messages coming through the Fed messages while doing a tail on that messages.
I just wanted to know, I mean, how exactly are you differentiating? This particular producer has write access, this one doesn't. How do you differentiate that?
Okay. So in that case, I don't know much about that part, but basically what they do is that they directly do that after once your project is set up, you have to like send up security check and write code or based on the they write scripts and do blocking on that stuff. So
any more questions?
Okay, thanks then.